That's modern slangs. You see, we are in a society where you hear things like, I owe nobody this, I owe nobody that, it's my body, I have to do what I want with it. You see, that's how we got to this level of irresponsibility. Broken relationship, broken homes, reckless society. Let me tell you the truth and tell yourself this truth. Don't allow anyone to deceive you. You owe people a lot. I mean a lot. You owe people respect, you owe people empathy, you owe people compassion, you owe people regards, you need to be of good character, and you owe people accountability. A lot of modern slangs have come up today in order to replace derogatory terms like, I am tripping for him. You hear things like, it's my crush. You see someone that is having a dirty feeling for opposite sex, and you hear things like, it's my bestie. And so you see things like slay queen, you see things like dress to kill. I think for today I want to talk about the slay queen of a thing. What's slay queen? Urban Dictionary defines a slay queen as a young and naive girl who apparently do not date broke men. She spends hours on social media, on Instagram, on Facebook, on all the social media trying to get attention of men. See, there are girls who do not have wealthy background, but they appear as if they do. And what's the intention? They're dressing to slay, they're dressing to kill. And the worst of it is the dress to kill. Dress to kill is an idiom, meaning wearing clothes to attract attention and to impress. Of course, Dress to Kill was a film that was acted by Brian De Palma in 1980. And funny enough, today's society, you hear our young girls, African, Nigerian girls saying things like, I want to dress to kill. Rape is on the rise. Domestic violence is on the rise. I am not justifying the people, the animalistic tendency of men trying to rape girls that are poorly dressed or indecently dressed. But fact remains, you shouldn't be the reason why your brother falls. The Bible, the good book, Matthew chapter 18 verse 6 says, if anyone causes these little ones to fall, new believers, fresh believers, to stumble, it will be better for them to have a large millstone hang around their neck and be drowned into the depths of the sea. You see, if you look at the story of David and Bathsheba, of course, it's a normal routine for us to blame David for sleeping with Bathsheba. But fact is, if Bathsheba had bathed in the closure of her room, or had bathed in an enclosure so that David would not sight her from a distance, I mean, imagine that. I mean, from a distance, David sighted her and called another person to confirm that she was Uriah's wife, and she called on her, and then he had a carnal knowledge of her. If David did not cite Bathsheba, David would not have committed that sin. David had an animalistic tendency, and of course, he committed that sin, which is against humanity. But while we blame David, we should understand that the act of Bathsheba was innocent, just like you owe nobody nothing. But at the end of the day, that was what causes David to fall. What are we trying to say? While we try to copy things from the society of today, you call yourself sleeping, you dress to kill, understand that your dressing can be the reason why another person is falling. And so you should be conscious of the way you dress, the way you do things, because you owe people a lot. If we do, the society will be much of a better place. Thank you.